on another guy's dice. How about we keep this party polite? Never get out of my sight. Stick with me, baby. I'm the guy that you came in with. Let me a lady. Let me a lady.
And the great experiment begins. How you doing, everybody? It is the TeeMonster. Some of you guys know me as Twitch Dad. And today I am finally grooming this nasty piece of growth that is currently on my face. So, okay. So before we begin, this is an unconventional stream, I admit. And this is, I've actually got Twitch Mom in the other room. She's actually... helping me co-host this. She's moderating chat, so she will be able to just honey. Yeah. What?
Successful Geek says aloha, Twitch.
Aloha, Adam. How are you, sir?
And Successful Geek says started my grind for recluse.
Nice. Well done. Well done. Now, honey, if anybody gets out of hand in chat, you just tap on their name, and you can. Otherwise, I gotta step away, and I gotta do that.
Okay, so we've got Sparky Broken Halo.
Hi, Sparky.
Good afternoon. Using the Twitch Dad emote.
Yes, I. Oh, hey.
And the Elder Unicorn says hi, Twitch
Mom. Hey, how you doing, Unicorn? Okay, so. What we are doing is we are talking about grooming. But first thing I think I should explain is what exactly is Twitch Dad. If you're new to the stream, and you're wondering what Twitch Dad is, and this is going to feel very weird because I can see myself in my peripheral vision. But I'm focusing on the mirror because the I've actually got the webcam angled onto the mirror so that you can get the full beard thing. All right. So first, let's start off with who is Twitch Dad and how did this all come to be? All right. So last month I was raided by Markiplier and his YouTube channel, which they call themselves the Kick Club. They helped me with a charity that I was doing in cohorts with Steve the Blind Gamer Sailor. We were raising money for AOL gamers. We set out to make $500 and we wound up making over $5,300 in the course of October. But most of that was made on the night that that Markiplier and his Kick Club did their reverse charity. If you go to my blog over at tmorris.com, you'll see it all there. But that was how Twitch Dad came to be, because Markiplier referred to me as having big dad energy, and everybody started calling me Twitch Dad during the stream. And then I wound up shaving for charity. The dare was, if you guys could get me to $5,000, I'll shave my beard. And I did. So what you're looking at right now is a month worth of growth. And the reason I'm doing Twitch Dad as the stream today is because there were people while I was shaving, I was talking through it about how to shave, and people really were getting into it. They were saying, I never learned this stuff. I can't talk to my father. A lot of people who were talking to me about it were from the LGBTQ plus community. So there was a lot of comments that made me go, maybe this should be a thing. So I asked a few friends of mine in the community whether or not I should do something like this, and they all thought it was a great idea. So that's why I'm here. I am doing grooming tips specifically for shaving, and I think we should just go ahead and get started. And I figured
Successful Geek says, you know, it's easy to shave with Leviathan's breath.
Yeah. Thank you, Adam. Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
And you're not using that today.
I'm not using Leviathan's breath today, but I am going to talk a little bit about what I'll be using and what others use. Now, let me go on ahead and say that your mileage may vary on what works for you and what works for everybody. Okay, Also, I want to get a quick sound check since this is the first time I've ever done this completely on the laptop. I'm actually trying out the stuff that I talk about in the book, and I want to make sure that it's working okay. So if everybody can hear me okay, just give me a quick shout out in the chat. I would appreciate it. If the music's too loud, just let me know. I'll go ahead and turn that down. Anyway, so we're going to be shaving today. And as you can see...
I can hear you fine. Sounds good.
Great.
To you.
Fantastic. So...
Cat Flips Bay says, hi, do you know any Turkish words?
No, I do not. Afraid not.
I see the Turkish bars.
I struggle with English, so that should just tell you right there. The only other language I can really speak is nerddom. So there you have it.
Sparky Broken Halo says, can hear vids a little choppy.
Vids a little choppy? That's interesting. Shouldn't be choppy.
Jay Murdoch says, bit of an echo, time to soundproof your bathroom.
Well, okay. We are streaming for the bathroom. Like I said, this is the very first Twitch Dad.
Yeah, they're not complaining about the audio. The problem I seem to be having is stuttering video. Not sure if it's my end. Yeah,
that's weird.
Let me
real quick. Well, now I'm on Vlad the Poker, so it shouldn't be a problem. But Well, I do have a lot of stuff running. Maybe this will help. I'm gonna go on ahead and just take the music out completely. I'm just gonna quit Spotify altogether, and maybe that'll help.
We need a video as smooth as T's shave.
There we go.
This is JR
Murdoch. How you doing, JR? Good to see you. Thank you for joining us on stream. All right, so the first thing.
It might be because we got up on the.
No, it's actually. I think it might be because I'm running Spotify. Everything is running right now off of the laptop. So Spotify may have been causing some issues. That's all right. That's all right. So this should be interesting. All right. So first thing about shaving. Right now, what I've got going on is the neck beard look, and I'm the first one to. Oh, by the way, this is not sponsored by Origin anyway. I'm wearing an extra large shirt because I didn't really want to be shirtless for this podcast for this Twitch stream. I hope you appreciate that.
Sound runs fine on his end.
Okay.
Filled with awesome. Great to be here. And Space Ace Alex said, this is such a lovely wholesome idea.
Well, thank you for that. And Kit, are you Kit? Thank you very much for that follow. I do appreciate it. So I'm not being sponsored by Origin. This was just the only extra large shirt I could find. But as you can see, right now I'm currently sporting the neckbeard look. There are some people who can pull off the neckbeard look. And I am not shaming or dismissing the neckbeard look in any way. But there are two people in this world that I will tell you right now cannot pull off the neckbeard look. One of them is me. The other one is Donald Trump Jr. That's for another stream altogether. And who's hosting me? Oh, the other unicorn with the host. Thank you very much. I appreciate that, unicorn. Yeah, cleared up video problems. I saw that. Yeah. So the first thing you got to do, I want to do is actually just get rid of this whole neck beard look, because man, has this been itching like crazy. This has been nasty, and I got to make sure I got to look here, not here. All right. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start up some hot water.
Hot or warm?
Hot. The reason I'm going with hot water is because when you want to loosen up the beard, you want it to be, which is why a lot of times you'll hear people say it's best to shave after a shower than it is before a shower, unless you want to leave the shower running and get the steam going in here. It basically softens up the beard and allows you to get a little nicer shave. One thing's for certain is you don't want to shave with a cold razor.
Really?
No, you don't. You don't want to.
Warm up the razor?
You want to warm up the razor as well. Yeah, there you have it. Hey, how you doing, Jenny? That is Jenny from the block.
Yeah, JR Murdoch's neck beard itch to high L. Shave,
Grizzly
Adam. Shave.
Yes, I have friends who do the neck beards, and they do them like absolute pros. That's the first thing I'll tell you.
I think it's nice to have a place for the chin because it defines your chin a little better.
It does.
My personal opinion.
All right, so you can choose to wash your face, but when the hair is this thick, you're better off just warming up the beard. That's kind of what I'm doing right now. I'm just softening up the beard, warming it up a little bit. Just loosening it up, making it softer. And because it is so dense down here, taking a razor to it would be kind of ridiculous, because you're basically hacking through the jungle down there.
With a very tiny machete.
So
big guns?
So the first thing we're going to be using this, okay? So this is a personal groomer. I'll get into personal and the groomer because this covers everything. But you've got an electric razor up here, and then you've got a hair trimmer down here. Now, if you remember from the Markiplier stream, I took off this, which I'll explain what this is, this attachment, in just a second, and I went straight with this razor. Now, the problem with that, this will cut through just about anything, but these blades right here are a lot sharper than the blades down here. And when you're cutting through this much hair, yeah, these may work better, but you're more than likely to nick yourself. If you remember, I was actually bleeding on the stream.
That's right.
That's how it happened.
Says, does it do bikini lines?
Yes, it does. We'll be talking about that a little later, Jenny. Trust me.
She says be careful.
We'll be talking about that a little later. So first let's cut through here. There you go.
J.R. Murdoch says, as much as T-Talk, but glad he's not using a straight razor. No Sweeney Todd for you.
No Sweeney Todd's for me.
I think Jenny's nervous that you're going to cut yourself again.
Yeah, I don't want to necessarily cut myself again. Oh my God, there's my neck. Feels so good to see that neck again.
You've got a neck.
Got a neek.
I think everyone's got this bated breath, like, are we going to watch T put his own throat today?
No, I don't think so. Now, one thing about these particular groomers is, because my hair is so thick, I have to occasionally stop shaving and clean out the blade part here, because it does stack up. And when this hair stacks up, one, the blades stop working, and two, it actually the blades actually work harder. And because they work harder, that means it's going to get more and more uncomfortable. But right now, I'm just looking to get some shape in here.
Anything to work, and then she says, "You're looking good. Looking good. Take care." Quincy Aphid says, "I return." Leaning forward, right. Put your face under the chat box, FYI.
Trying to, yeah, I know, because this is a brand new little template I put together for myself. So I'm trying not to lean in here, but lean over here. So I am.
Tricky.
It's tricky setup. This is a brand new setup. It's pretty tricky. I'm very proud with what I put together, but it is tricky. It is very tricky. All right. So I've done a good amount of shaving with the personal shaver here. I can go on ahead and get a little more here, but this is the plight of the electric razor. Electric razors work fine for shaving. But nothing beats a razor. Nothing beats it. Okay, that's just the way it is. I mean, the advertisers will like to tell you, oh, you'll get a clean shave just as you would with a regular razor. If you really want to know how it breaks down, you've got a straight razor, which I've had done before. It's a fantastic shave, but it should be only done in the hands of a professional.
Sweeney, not
Todd. And then there's the regular razor, something like this, and then finally you've got the electric razor, or as this one is called again, this is the personal groomer, and this is from Philips Norelco. Now I'm going to go with the sharper ends because I forgot how thick my neck beard can get, so we're going to go a little harder into this. Just remember that just because you're using an electric razor doesn't mean you can't nick yourself, especially if you're using something like this. Now all electric razors have these type of trimmers on here. And people will wonder, what are they used for? Well, they're used for this. for like beard and deep shaving, because an electric razor is not going to cut through this. And if it did, it'd be very painful. So let's go on ahead. Let's carefully start going through the rest of the neck.
Jay asks, I keep raising the clip to poke my head in. I am not poking my head in there. You need, it's quite a setup you've got in there.
Now there are all different styles of beards that people rock. The beard style that I tend to go for is the style that that tends to stay close to the jawline.
The Big Lovinsky said, "This is the worst Gillette advert ever." Such ads are shit.
Thank you, Marv.
If only we were being sponsored.
If only we were being. Oh no, Gillette's not going to sponsor this because I'm going to be talking about the Dollar Shave Club in a minute.
No, they own
Harry's. I'm pretty sure Gillette owns Harry, because while Harry is in, the stores, Dollar Shave Club is not.
Ah.
At least that's if I remember correctly. I could be wrong on that. The other nice thing about these personal groomers is that they both are dry and wet shave, which means they can get wet. Most electric razors cannot, but this is a personal groomer. And it works really, really well for in wet.
Marv's heading out to shop real quick, and then he'll be back.
All right, I should still be here, Marv. Don't worry. All right.
J.R. Murdoch says, "I'll buy that for $1." folks, the Avid 767 says, "Dollar is $20 here." Where is folks the Avid?
He's in South Africa.
$20.
Yeah. By the way. Instead of reading out for everybody's name, find a keyword and just go with that. Like with aphid, I just use aphid. Sparky, I just use Sparky, etc., etc. Okay. Except for, and then you got Marv, and then there's Marv.
Yeah.
And there's Marv. Okay, so now I'm going to start defining this area again. I'm going to use this very gently.
Successful Geek says, "Looks like Schick owns Harry, and I love Harry's razors."
Oh, Schick. Okay. Schick. For a second, I thought you said shit. I'm like, damn. But, okay, Schick. All right, I knew one of them was bought up, but I couldn't remember if it was Gillette or not.
Dollar Shave is acquired by Unilever.
Okay.
For $1 billion, wow.
Yeah, yeah, they got themselves a nice little payday. They got themselves a nice little payday. All right.
Apparently 20% of their people are women.
Which is probably why I've seen a lot of women join the Dollar Shave Club. The first person I actually heard about it from, Lauren. Or at least I saw their products up close.
Unicorn says, "You want me to help or let Pip do it?"
No, I don't mind you helping, Unicorn. Not at all.
Unicorn, I'm just reading stuff out loud.
Yeah, yeah.
Aphid says, "Get the waxing paper. Or whatever the hell it's called."
We're going to be talking about waxing in
different. Waxing? That's
yeah, we're going to talk about waxing near the end.
Live. I think that probably violates some terms of service, right?
Probably does. Depends on what you're waxing. Okay. All right. So there you go. All right. So no nicks so far. That's good. No nicks so far. And thanks everybody for all the comments. I really do appreciate it. You're keeping Pip and Unicorn on their toes. I appreciate
well,
that.
Unicorn says, "I'll let Pip have some fun. I don't have any fun." So you know, it's nice.
Actually, there's a there. Hopefully soon, Pip is going to be having some fun on the stream because they just recently announced that Agrit Suco is getting a video game.
Oh yeah.
It's going to be available on Steam. And I'd really like to see Pip play it.
He all right. Says, "Waxing is terrifying."
Okay. Sorry. All right. So now we get to what this is. So this right here is a trimmer setting that allows you to decide how thick you want the beard to be. This is important because when you start growing facial hair, when you start growing beards, hair just goes everywhere, at least for me. I mean, I got a lot of loose hairs around here, and I want them closely cropped as much as possible, because when you're growing a beard in and it's and it starts to grow, hair just goes in every direction. That's what this is for. Now, if I were to do a setting of one, most of the time the setting of one will take the thickness of the beard and really bring it down to like almost skin level. I mean, real small hairs. It almost looks like stubble with me because my beard is so fine. So I'm going to go to setting of two.
Do you think your beard's fine?
I think my beard is just fine, baby. No.
Well,
the problem is that because my beard is fair.
It's fair color. I mean, the thickness of the hair is still
fair. Yeah. So I'm going with two, and then you should hear it cut through some of the thicker parts of my beard. Yeah. These are all the wayward hairs that are in my beard. But if I were to go with a setting of one, that would cut down my beard to roughly, it would look like stubble. So I want to give it just a little bit of depth.
Oh, Jay is leaving. He's around. Happy grooming.
Thank you, Jay. Appreciate it. Okay.
Now, I've got a question for you.
Yeah?
Since you've got some gray hairs going on there, are they a different texture or thickness to...
No, they're just gray and annoying.
They're just gray? They're not...
They're just gray and reminders that, yes, memento mori. That's what gray hairs are, memento mori. That's exactly what gray hairs are. But you'll notice, though, when you're shaving, even at a setting of two, what you should notice is, and the same rules apply, when the shaver starts to get a little full, you just go on ahead and you just tap it out. For those of you joining this inaugural Twitch stream for Twitch Dad, I do appreciate you all being here. Again, this was the whole persona of Twitch Dad came from Markiplier and the Kick Club. I was raided by them back in October, and he commented that I had Big Dad energy, and that apparently found a root with the with his community, and they started calling me Twitch Dad. And I've decided to go ahead and lean into it, especially after some of the comments that I saw in chat. It was very humbling what people were saying about the whole shaving lesson. So I thought, well, you know what? When the beard gets back, I want to go on ahead and do this as a proper stream.
Well,
and
makes you realize that not everybody has, you know, somebody to show them such things.
And in all fairness, I actually learned from trial and error. It was not because my dad didn't care. Or my dad was
a
jerk.
You had a great dad.
I had a fantastic dad, and he shaved with this. In fact, he had one of those old school razors that actually opened up, and you put in like the razor blades. Those thin razor blades are now hard to find. That's what he used for years. And he did not share. He offered to teach me how to shave, but I was using an electric razor under the pretense that it was close enough, but. The older I got, the more I was like, I think I'm going to have to teach myself how to shave. And this was before the days of the internet, before the days of a Twitch dad that I could rely on. So I've learned through a lot of trial and error. I've picked up tips from different websites, different places.
And from our favorites.
And from our favorites, particularly
Jonathan,
JVN, over at Queer Eye. The man knows his grooming. And...
Aphid says, gray hair actually runs in my family on my mother's side, so there is a good chance that I will have silverish hair by next year. Early gray hair. Well, you know what? People are rocking gray hair.
Oh, yeah. Days. I had a friend from the Ren Fair who went silver fox like in her 30s. And at first she hated it, then she embraced it, and then... People around her were actually, when people started dyeing their hair gray,
yeah.
She was like, what the hell are you ladies doing?
There are people, yeah, you know, people in their 20s dyeing their hair gray.
Yeah.
I mean, I think it looks very nice. My grandmother had wonderful gray hair. It sort of started off like steel, like slate gray.
Yeah.
And it went all the way down her hair to end up white.
See, I got what I call the mailman's hair because... Because my father and my brother, my father, he was losing his hair. And my brother is, my brother also has very thin hair, and I think he's losing his hair as well. I, however, have had this head of hair all my life. Like, and it. While that's great and all, the thing is, I know that if I'm getting gray in the beard, it's going to come up here eventually. So
Eventually.
Right.
Unicorn says, twin side razor. I used those before.
Yeah, twin side razors. Thank you. Your twin side razors.
Nate Fu.
How you doing, Nate?
Said, oh no, what did I stumble in on? Don't worry. This is PG. This is, you know.
Yeah, we're keeping it family friendly this go round. We're keeping it family friendly.
Nathan said, my hair is way too curly. I either cut it short or I look like a meth addict.
So,
what do you call it? What, Leaf Garrett hair?
Yeah, I call this my Leaf Garrett hair. When you can see it just a little bit, but when it gets long, I start to get real wavy hair, and then it becomes almost like Leaf Garrett from the 70s. Not Leaf Garrett present day. Leaf Garrett present day is pretty much a mess. Okay, so one last thing with the trimmer is again, I'm gonna take the beard comb off. And then I'm just going to touch up the edges around the top and bottom of the mustache. Because what you'll notice is that even though it looks even, when you get close up, you'll notice that it may appear a little uneven. And that's another thing that the personal groomer, and if anyone was curious, this is the Phillips Norelco personal groomer. They run about $20-$30, if that. Target's got them dirt cheap, and you'll notice that there's different prices and everything. What are you paying for? You're paying for attachments. And you're paying for what they can do, and also how long they'll last and how long. And Phillips Norelco is a very trustworthy brand. I think I've been using this trimmer for almost 2 years now, and I tend to go through trimmers like every 5 years, and that's on a good sprint. But the reason I paid a little more for this one is that I wanted to make sure it was a trimmer that worked both in and out of the shower. Again, something else I'll talk about in a second. All right, so let's go ahead and let's trim this up. So we basically do this.
Aphid says, your hair goes wavy, mine follows no patterns, and sticks up constantly thanks to the heat conditions in South Africa.
Mm. One thing you'll notice what I'm doing here is I am placing the blade flat against the line of the line of my lip, and I'm just above it. But if I want to get some of the corners, I take the razor. It's off, obviously. I take the razor and I just lean it out a little bit, and then I'm using this part right here to get some of the corners. So, okay, go ahead, hon.
Nate first is beauty tips with Twitch Dad. Oh, Aphid said, speaking of beauty, I got a nose job last year.
Oh, wow.
Not so that I could look better, so that I could actually breathe through my nose.
I've had friends who've gone through that too, yeah.
It's important.
One thing you got to be careful about, and always have a towel close by.
Yeah.
When you're grooming around the corners of your mouth, some hair might go into your mouth. Oh, I got it right there.
Unicorn says, wet dry shaver, I have one. Is that what you've got right there? Wet
yep.
dry? You could take that into the shower. Could you in the shower and shave?
I'll talk about that in a second.
Yeah. I have questions. I have my own set of questions.
Okay. All right. So that's the bottom, and just right now you can see just how, as I lean into the mirror, you can see how clean the line is now between my lip and the bottom of the mustache. I'm going to go to the top of the mustache, but I want to talk about this little soul patch bit first. I usually let this grow to about here, just so I can complete the line. It's this outer part right here that kind of drives me nuts, so I do this.
Huh.
That's a little better. I prefer to have a line here going from here to the chin. Some people just save the what is called the soul patch. If I was completely clean shaven except for this, it's called the soul patch. Some people like it, some people don't. It's really up to you. But what I've noticed whenever I have a soul patch is these bits at the very ends, at the very corners, they never grow out. So So sometimes you have to contort your face and make the blade work for you.
Nate Fu said, I had to make sure to buy a trimmer that works not only wet dry, but also AC and battery. I've had bad luck with battery only. Having AC as an option means I never have a dead trimmer. But yours is a chargeable one, right?
Yeah, mine's rechargeable. So mine's rechargeable.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, Avon said, just completely new tea and have Pip do all the talking. Unfortunately, I don't know anything about shaving a beard.
Okay, now we get to the tricky bit. So I'm taking the trimmer and I'm moving down the top of the top of the mustache. But here's the thing. When you screw up a shave job, chat, you pretty much have to wait until the hair grows back. I remember one time I wasn't paying attention. It was really early in the morning. And I cut a line right through this beard. So I had to go to the goatee for a while and let the rest of it shave out. So yeah, that was grow out. That was kind of embarrassing. But when it comes to sculpting, this is when the groomers work really well. But you just want to make sure that you don't go too far in, otherwise you're going to make yourself a pencil. Now, if you want the pencil thin mustache, you know, go for it. I mean, but here's the thing about pencil thin mustaches. In my opinion, they only work for people who have really dark hair. Like,
yeah,
you know, if you've got those raven locks of hair, boom. I'll give a perfect example. There's a guy I met at TwitchCon. He is a candidate. If he ever decided he wanted to go for the pencil thin mustache, it's this guy. His name is Dan of the Past. So if I could get a shout out for Dan of the Past, all one word. He's not only got that really dark hair, but he's got that almost Greek Italian kind of look. I'm using swarthy in the nicest possible way because he's a really good guy. But if he did the pencil thin mustache, oh my God, he would look like he would step off the set of Casablanca. He's got that kind of feature about him. I can't do that. If I ever did a pencil thin mustache back in my actor days, I would literally have to take mascara and darken the hair in my beard.
That's
let me tell
you, another story.
Mascara in the beard is really, really hard to get out. All right, here we go.
Well, Ethan thinks I should be writing a script. There is no script. This house does not live on scripts. We do everything off script, right?
Yep.
Unicorn says his is cordless. He also said, get out the Sharpie. OMG.
I only do that when I'm tracking hurricanes. Now, one of the things you can do to make sure that you're not going too far into the beard is listen very carefully for these little... When you hear the razor cut hair, that's when you know you're close enough. So right now, I'm getting there. It's nice to see a familiar face again. Here we go. You can just hear it over the sound of the razor. I don't know if you can hear it in chat, but I can hear it. All right. So now the beard is trimmed up enough where it's razor ready, as I would call it. There is no I don't know if there is an official terminology for a beard to be razor ready, but in my opinion, this is what I call razor ready. So I can't pull at it. It's still a little rough. I think I've got all the wayward hairs. Hang on a minute. Sometimes you have to go over spots you shaved just a little bit. Just a little bit more. Yeah, okay. Oh, it's nice. Hardest part, you're going to be doing a lot of this when you're shaving too, because you want to make sure that the lines are even. All right, we're setting this aside for now. Again, this is the Phillips & Relco personal groomer. You can get them at pretty much Target, Walmart, any of those stores. They run about anywhere from 20 to 30 bucks, and they're worth it. Either go with one like Nate Fu said, either go with one that's got a cord, or go with one that is rechargeable. And if you're traveling, you might want to think. It depends on how long. If I took this away for a weekend, it'll stay charged for the whole weekend. If it's brand new out of box, the charge might last for an entire week. But after about 5 days, you're going to notice that the motors aren't going as fast.
It's not good if it starts to slow down.
Right? No, it's not. No, that's
pulling the hair.
It starts pulling the hair as opposed to shaving the hair, which is kind of a pain. All right. So first things first about blades in general. So, as I said earlier, I'm part of the Dollar Shave Club, and I really like their products. They're inexpensive. It's a bit like if you get coffee from King's Coast Coffee. You've heard me talk about King's Coast Coffee before. If you join the Dollar Shave Club, it's roughly the same thing. They will time it where when you're ready for new products, they'll send you whatever you need, and you can customize what you're getting from them every 3 to 6 months. You can also change the mailing pattern as well. I'm on a 3 month pattern with them, and one thing I won't need for the next, let's say 3-6, for the next year, are blades. Now blades last roughly, it all depends on how much you shave. Since I'm grooming and not just taking care of a beard, I probably will go this should last me a whole year. But the thing to do, if you take a look at the blade here, you'll notice that the top strip, the moisturizer strip, is starting to fade. When it starts to fade, that's when you want to go on ahead and put on a new blade. So I go on ahead and I pop it. And then when you want to bring the blades in, you take your whichever version of razor, because there's a whole different flavor of razors like this. But you basically bring the switch up, hook it, let it go, and it doesn't work. Come on, get up.
Ethan says you can hear it because the screams of the hairs are closer to your head.
Yeah.
and then get some shaving cream for refreshments while you groom yourself.
Well, we're going to talk about that in just a minute. All right, so there's the new head, and you'll see that it's like a real bright green versus the faded green. And I want to say I was actually getting ready to switch out blades, and then that was when the Markiplier raid happened. So, yeah, I was putting it off. I had put this off for a month, but I want to say that these blades last me roughly 3 months. But if you're shaving a lot, then chances are you're going to go through blades a lot faster. All right, so that's when now, just to loosen up these blades to make them go a little easier on your face. We're gonna go on ahead and we're gonna heat up these blades. But before I get into that, let's talk about prep scrubs. Now, if you've ever worked in the entertainment industry, and I was an actor once upon a time, one of the things that you're going to hear a lot of people talk about, especially with taking care of the face, is you're gonna hear people talk about facial care. You're gonna be talking about facial products. And what I find funny about this is that this is the brand from the Dollar Shave Club. This is Dr. Carver's mandatory prep scrub. Now, you can buy this stuff if you want to, but you could actually go to any supermarket right now and get yourself a tub of facial scrub. And guess what? It's the same stuff as this. And if you want it, you're gonna have to track with me on this. If you want a really good breakdown of how to take care of your skin, I'm going to recommend to you watching American Psycho. I like having Pip on the stream because it's like having a laugh track. But yes, American Psycho has a segment where Christian Bale, as Patrick Bateman, is talking about how I do a facial prep and then I do a facial peel. I don't use aftershave because that's alcohol. That'll make your skin dry and you'll wrinkle faster. Hey, do you like Huey Lewis in the news? I mean,
okay. Null says I ended up leaving Dollar Shave Club on their default rotation, and I've got like 7 to 8 boxes at this point still full. Good product, but I certainly don't shave as much as the default timing.
But you see, that's the thing,
that's like many of those delivery.
Right, things. Right. That's what happened with King's Coast. You got to tweak it, and then when you get the system down, you're set. Right. Also, the thing to know about Dollar Shave Club, and I don't know if this happened while you were with the Dollar Shave Club, but now you can tell them, hey, I don't want razors. I don't want this. I don't want that. and they'll put it off until the next order. Then you go in and you just have to go, oh, okay, yeah, I don't want this. I mean, I'll put this off. I'll take it off the list entirely. They have it set up to where you can really customize everything now. But if you want to get a good commentary, apart from Queer Eye, I would suggest watch the opening segment of American Psycho. Because when Patrick Bateman is talking about his facial routine in the morning, it actually makes a lot of sense.
He's not wrong.
He's not wrong there.
Later on,
he's not wrong. He's incredibly wrong when he takes Jared Leto to task with Huey Lewis and the News playing in the background. That's a given. That's a given. But yeah, I was thinking about it this morning. I was like, wow, yeah, American Psycho, great resource for facial care.
I even said, drink the shaving cream, and then Big Marv said, this is probably against terms of service.
Probably not recommended. But no, seriously, you could go out right now and get facial scrub. But the thing is, and dudes have this weird thing about facial scrub and beauty care. And look, you're taking care of yourself. You are taking care of yourself. And especially with this type of facial scrub, you're prepping your beard, you're prepping your skin for a razor to go across it, okay? You're taking a razor, a sharp object, against your skin. So facial scrubs are going to help not only loosen up the beard, but it's going to help out. It's going to soften up the beard. It's going to soften up the whiskers, and it will make shaving a much better experience. Now, I'm going to go on ahead and run through this so you can see what it will look like. You want, I would suggest you want to work with water as hot as you can deal with. But one of the other reasons why, if you go to a professional barber, which sometimes I do, there's a place in where I live called the Old Town Man Cave. And at the Old Town Man Cave, they do the towel on the face. It's great. But you know, I will tell you this, chat. If you go to a professional barber and they wrap your face in the hot towel, it's both relaxing and unnerving at the same time. It's relaxing because they'll sometimes put herbs in there, and they'll have it really nice and hot. It really just feels absolutely fantastic. But it gets unnerving because every Western and every gangster movie that you saw as a kid and as an adult comes back at you. And you're just like, if Capone's men come through the door, I'm screwed. So, you know, it's just something to consider.
Unicorn thinks Marv should be the guest host.
Well, you know, if Marv ever pays us a visit,
you can come home.
We have a guest room, Marv. That's too hot.
I even said water at 292 degrees. If you want to boil an egg.
Hot enough to boil an egg, Your Majesty. All right, so here we go.
Your face is not an egg.
Your face is not an egg.
Do not boil it.
All right.
Oh. Kelvin. What, like the sun? Ethan, I really think you really should get your own grooming cream.
So this is what the facial scrub looks like. And honestly, you put it on like war paint. Smear a little here, smear a little here, and then smear along the neck. Now
Null says, but hey, at least you're divine. In a fancy movie style. Mavitsky says, I'm not made of fucking money.
But Marv, if you come here for, say, I don't know, GCX, afterwards, I'll show you all the good spots of DC.
Well, Marv is saying, get my channel like 500 subs.
Now, what I'm doing right now, chat, just so you know, I mean, I don't have to do the forehead or my nose, but honestly, when they say it's a pre-shave scrub, it's a facial scrub. Just go for it. And what you want to do is you want to move back and forth across your face, especially where you're going to be shaving. And this is going to exfoliate your skin. It's not only going to soften up the beard, but it's also going to soften up your skin. It's going to feel great. But here's the other thing to keep in mind. You do not want to do this every day.
Oh, you
don't? You do not want to exfoliate, because basically you're exfoliating dead skin. You're removing dead skin off of yourself. But if you do it every day, eventually you're going to run out of dead skin.
Yeah.
And then pretty much you're turning your face into a into a like a stone you would want to wash clothes against. So you just don't want to do that.
You want every
Other day.
Every other day.
Yeah.
Your beautiful thing is your face will fall apart.
Right. And that's what Dollar Shave Club recommends as well. Every other day you want to do this. Now,
the Dollar Shave Club sends you like information.
Oh yeah, they said they do articles on this sort of stuff. They've got a really, really good website on this as well. One thing to be careful though, when you're working with scrubs, whether it's marketed as a pre-shave scrub, or whether it's a beauty scrub, or what have you, keep this in mind. There is stuff in the soap. And when you cut around your eyes, be real careful. Once or twice, when I was using a scrub, I would get some of the particulates into my eye.
Oh, no.
That's no bueno.
You shouldn't put it around the skin around your eyes is very thin.
Yeah, you would never go into the brow.
Just underneath.
Yeah. About as close as here.
Yeah. Imagine you're a raccoon. Make a raccoon mask.
Or a footballer. something like that. All right.
Unicorn said he thought about doing the Dollar Shave
Club. It's worth it. I really enjoy it.
It's pretty good. The toothpaste is good.
Whatever. Yeah, the toothpaste is bad. I love it. All right. So we've done our pre-scrub. So now we get to what do you use? All right. And I'm actually going to do like a flashback to a 70s commercial where they would shave with one product on one side and one product on the other.
Mark says my brother does and gets loads of stuff from it. Maybe you could steal some of his stuff, Mark.
Mark's got great skin. He's got fantastic skin. When we held one another it's too much, Marv. Terms of service. All right, so let's talk about shaving cream. There are basically two types of shaving cream. There's standard shaving cream and there's shave gel. This is the one that I tend to use when I used to work with shaving gels. This is the Dove Men Care. It's for sensitive skin because I started with shaving cream, and here's my thoughts on shaving cream. It is there for the benefit of the razor. It helps the razor move across. Now yesterday, Unicorn was telling me about something called the wet shave, which I'd never heard of before. But the wet shave is where you basically just use hot water, and that's it. If you're an outdoorsy guy, if you're a military guy, if you're like in extreme situations and you're doing something like that, I think that's okay. Wet shave is better than a dry shave. And again, with a movie reference, if you want to see what a dry shave looks like, all you got to do is watch the original Predator. Bill Duke in Predator, he's the bald black dude from Predator. At one point, he is just throughout the entire mission that they're in South America, he's just dry shaving.
Wow.
Now, granted, it's to show how manly he is. I mean, that's just, you know.
Well, his skin will be messy.
He's freaking Bill Duke. I mean.
So, Ethan said Colgate is good toothpaste, help you bite down freezing cold ice cream without flinching.
There's that.
Keeps my friends out. Unicorn says foam one side, gel the other.
Well, I'm getting it. Yeah. Foam one side, gel the other. Exactly. So I started using Edge, which was the first gel or the most common shave gel that went on the market. And what it would do is it was a gel that foamed on your face, and that's what men's skincare, that's what Dove's men's care, their shave gel does. It basically all shave gels do that. They basically foam up as you apply it. Now the upside with a foam versus a gel is that the gel not only helps the razor along, it also helps your skin heal faster. It's great for sensitive skin. I have sensitive skin, so I have to be very careful about that. We would use this, but what I'm showing off is what I'm using now. And this is the stuff that I swear by, but this is the stuff that got me there. So we're going to talk about shave butter and shave gel. No, sorry, shave lotion. What's the difference?
Well, Successful Geek has shave oil, which is amazing too. Not sure if you've ever used that.
No, I've never used that. But shave oil has a lot in common with shave butter and shave lotion in that both are transparent. And this is what I'll show you. First off, Here's what shaved butter looks like. All right. So it really is. Now, I wouldn't put this on my toast, obviously. But
tasty.
Yeah. But what the nice thing about shaved butter is that it's invisible. And what you do is you go on ahead and you pop that on. And this helps the blade move along. It's also moisturizing your skin. And I tried this stuff through the Dollar Shave Club. I've never heard of shave butter before until I started doing the Dollar Shave Club. And I love this stuff. This is great. This is great if you've got sensitive skin. Now with shave, whoa, there's a sub. Sir Jellyfish with the sub. Sir Jellyfish, subscribed for 2 months in a row. Thank you for that sub. Man, that made me jump. Okay, here we go. So,
jellyfish shave is my question.
Do jellyfish shave very carefully because otherwise they sting themselves.
That's right. So, Successful Geek recommends a stuff called from Walmart called Shave Secret. That's amazing.
Okay.
Unicorn said, I've tried dry shaving, so the blade has to be sharp.
Yeah, it has to be super sharp. And in Predator, Bill Duke is dry shaving with one of those Bic, like disposable razors, which are just hell on the skin. And, I forgot, I should probably be doing this.
So Aphid says, my school forces us to dry shave, if you leave it for too long.
Right.
A dry shave used razor if you leave it for too long. Ugh.
Yeah. Yeah. So here's...
Unicorn, have you shaved butter?
So you'll see that both the shave gel... Yeah.
Broken Halo says, whole things are shoulder height. Oh,
right. No sweat. I appreciate that. Okay, so this is the shave butter. There we go. It's backwards because I'm pointing at the mirror. But it's shave butter. Or I could do this. Oh, there you go. Hey, kid can be taught. There's shave butter, and then this is shave lotion I'm putting on. Now, the thing about gel and foam is that to really, especially with the gel. To moisturize your skin a little bit, they suggest that you leave the lotion, that you leave the shaving cream on for an amount of time. With shave butter and shave lotion, and I'm assuming shave oil as well, you don't have to do that. And as you can see, this is what it looks like visibly. And the stuff that I'm using right here is called, there we go. It's 1821. Shaving slide. I know that sounds dirty, doesn't it?
Shaving slide.
Shaving slide. That's the name of it. But it's basically a lotion. Now, the advantage of a lotion over shave butter. Both are pretty much identical. As you can tell, you can't. If you didn't watch me, you wouldn't have known which one. But the nice thing about both of these is that both of these moisturize your face. But the lotion works a little harder to moisturize your face. This stuff is more for you. This is for you and the blade. Now, one of the other things that that Dr. Carver, a.k.a. the folks at Dollar Shave Club, offer is this, the post-shave do. It's an aftershave lotion. And that's fine as well, but I've actually made the jump. I've gone from doing shave butter and lotion to just shave lotion. One of the other reasons why is also shave butter smells like shave butter. It's got a buttery scent to it. The shave lotion, this stuff smells phenomenal. I love this stuff. It is a spiced tobacco scent, and Pip loves it.
It smells great.
If the wifey loves it, then I love it. All right, so I have warmed up the blade, and we're gonna dispel this myth right here, right now. You never go against. Oh, damn it. Brilliant. On stream, first try, you never go against the grain. Is my razor busted? Damn it.
Your razor busted?
It's not hooking into the, it's not hooking in. Now it's hooked in. It better be hooked in.
That would be just typical, wouldn't it?
Typical. It's not hanging onto the beard. I don't know what's going on. I mean, it's not hanging onto the razor. I don't know what's going on.
I know.
Hang on. Hold, please.
Oh, Aphid has an exam, so they're going out.
All right.
Bye, Aphid. Good luck with the exam.
Okay. This is embarrassing. I can't. It's staying locked on. The minute I start shaving, it doesn't work.
Oh, no. Do you have another blade?
I have another. Hang on. I have another blade. If this doesn't work, you might have to run downstairs and get my razor out of my gym bag.
I'll prepare to run downstairs. Elder Unicorn used the Pro Streamer.
Pro streamer. Pro shaver is more like it. For fuck's sake, would you go downstairs and get my other razor?
Where is it?
You were playing War Dragons. You were playing fucking War Dragons when you're supposed to be moderating chat. Worst moderator ever. You suck. It's in my gym bag. I said it 3 times. It's in my gym bag. Wow, chat. She is playing freaking War Dragons. She was playing freaking War Dragons. I think I need Pro Mod. I'm almost afraid to shave with this now. Now watch. I send her downstairs. Now it's going to work. Nope. Oh, man. Okay. That's really weird, chat. I've never seen it do this before. And no, I'm not pressing the switch. I'm literally tugging at it right now. But watch. Let's see if it works. All right. Nope. Weird. I was doing so well, too.
Dollar Shave Club loses points.
Yeah, Dollar Shave Club is losing points quickly. I'd like to know why it's not working, though. That's weird.
Because you're on stream.
Thank you. Because I'm on stream. Story of my life. All right. So let me see.
Wank Dragons? Yes, Big Marv. That's what I was playing. Wank Dragons.
She was playing Wank Dragons, exactly.
You know me so well.
All right. Experiencing technical difficulties with his shave. Please stand by.
Successful Geek says, Harry's blades never do that, just saying.
You know what else doesn't do that? Leviathan's breath.
It's a tr- Well, Broken Halo said it's atrophy because you haven't used it for a moment. That could be true. Isn't that, but it's the handle.
Mm-hmm. Once more with feeling. All right. That is just ridiculous. It's as if the I think I see what if I'm looking at this right. See, right now I am tugging on this. Yeah, it's not hooking in completely. It's not locking into place. Oh, I don't want to cut myself on stream. That would be embarrassing. Because this is embarrassing. This isn't embarrassing enough. All right, one more time. Oh, I think I see the problem. I think.
That's not it either.
So what's supposed to happen is this is supposed to hook into there. It slips into place, but it doesn't lock. And I'm trying to figure out how to get it to lock, because it's supposed to lock before I before I put it in here.
Mark said he has hard hearing due to years of being exposed to loud music. Was he a technician or did he just go to a lot of loud music
events? Probably just went to a lot of loud music events.
Yeah. I saw someone who soloed the ribbon fight in 7 seconds, says Alfred. Alfred. What is Barb talking about? Liar's handshake, thunder coil, and a shotgun
Wow.
Oh,
he's talking about Destiny stuff. This is really disturbing because it's not working.
What? Sorry. Let me have a look at it. I'll have a look at it.
No, that's okay. Don't. Would you do me a favor? Put wood chips on the. All right. Meanwhile, downstairs, teenager child is basically telling the parents to snap to it. That's weird. Okay. Says it's in there. That's what she said. I know. I build up, and then this doesn't make me feel bad so much as it makes me feel bad for the Dollar Shave Club, because I've used their product before and it's never done this before. It's never just fallen apart like that. And it should be locking into place. Let me just give it a wiggle. Right now I'm tugging against it and it's not coming out, but watch what happens when I put it to my face. Give this a shot. I don't even get through a stroke. Wow. That is weird as. Give me a second, everybody. Talk amongst yourself. Yeah, I guess so. All right.
I'm back.
Excellent.
Did you get the shaver to work?
Nope. Still haven't gotten the shaver to work.
Good thing that Dollar Shave are not sponsoring this.
Well, Dollar Shave were sponsoring this, I'd be getting my money back. All right, so it just seems like this that
what must be bad, unicorn says.
Well, yeah, but the problem is that I did a second razor on it, and I mean, if I have to go through a third razor, that's going to be kind of ridiculous.
Yeah. Successful Geek says I've had 3 handles break from Dollar Shave Club.
Now he tells me. See, the funny thing is, look at this. I want you to watch this. So right now I'm doing this, right?
Yeah.
See that? I'm pushing against it. Now I'm going to drag it across my face.
What the?
Dollar Shave Club, you fail me. You fail me, Dollar Shave Club.
A complaint, a nastily worded complaint.
I think it's time that we did that.
Big Mar thinks it's a good website.
It's a fantastic website. But right now,
Unicorn says you just got a bad razor. It happens.
Well, no,
this is like the third one, right?
This is. I thought I had 2 of these, but apparently I do not.
Huh.
Let me just see, because I thought I had 2 razors. The problem is that
Unicorn says next order ask for a replacement.
Next one, I'm going to ask for my money back because...
How long did you have that handle?
This was the handle that I was introduced with.
Yeah.
I've had it since the beginning.
It's not that long, though.
No, it's not that long at all. What's worse is I can go onto their website and go, hey, guys, I just did a live stream.
I was going to show off
your fantastic product. Guess what? Didn't work out so well.
It failed
miserably. Now, here's one thing about shave butter that you got to be aware of, too. Your skin will pretty much soak it up like a sponge. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to struggle through this shave because I got no other razors. I've been pretty much on the Dollar Shave Club. But I am going to send them a link to the stream and go, hey, guys, guess what? Dollar Shave Club fail. You know what, Unicorn? Why don't you moderate chat? Because apparently Pip's got plenty to do with Yeah, okay, yeah.
Hey, look, but you've got a dragon war going on. Just get real. I'm here.
Yeah. Awesome.
I think people are being quiet. I think they're impressed with the, Are you warming up the water again?
Well, you could come in here and take a look.
Okay. Oh, you're being a fan of it.
All right, you know what? My wife is so freaking cocky.
Can you have a look at it?
Why don't you have a look at it?
You know, my dad's an engineer. I'm just saying. Okay. My professional opinion, it's bull.
I have tried every freaking way to snap this thing into place, and I'm running out of options, and I'm running out of blades.
Oh, I see. Okay.
It's supposed to do something that it's not doing.
Yeah, that is interesting.
Yeah, and then you tug at it, and it's fine.
Yeah.
Then the minute I start shaving with it, it gets stuck. it just collapses. It just breaks under the pressure.
Yeah. I wonder what it is. It's not
really? Miss War Dragons is stumped. Wow.
The dragon's been a dragon. Huh?
This is why she's off camera. She didn't want to fail miserably like I did on camera.
I'm just shaking it out.
Yep.
And I'm saying...
I feel vindicated now because she's struggling with it. The fact that she's struggling with it, I'm like, okay, great.
The thing I
wanted to say was the one thing you never want to do, and this is especially when your razor isn't working, you do not want to go against the grain. You never want to shave up. That has been one of the biggest myths that people have concerning shaving, is that when you shave up, you get a closer shave. To an extent, you do get a closer shave, but at the expense of your skin. Pretty much, you might as well be putting a cheese grater to your face, because what you're doing is you're literally ripping the hair out. And to give you an idea of what can happen when you start shaving up and again going against the grain, you get a lot of ingrown hairs, you get a lot of bumpy texture to your skin. It just tears up your skin in the worst possible way. There's a guy that is at my day job, and I can tell he does that. He shaves against the grain because he just looks like he's been in a bar fight.
That's my bit. I'll get my closest. I don't know if it's going to work.
Toss me the towel, please. Let's see if it works.
We'll see if it works.
If not, yeah, I'm going to be doing a very strongly worded... It feels better. It looks much better
manicured.
But let's see if I can actually get it to shave properly.
He's doing well. Leave the poor boy alone.
Nope. Still didn't work.
That's fine.
That is borked heavily. which means I've got to run out and go and get a razor because I haven't finished my shave. I can do it in phases, but I mean that's just ridiculous. That is utterly ridiculous. But one thing you'll notice I'm also not doing
it. At least he's not playing Wang Dragon or some shit.
Thank you, Marv. I appreciate that, Marv.
When people, when you need to burn some shit down, War Dragon is great.
Yeah, but when you're moderating your husband's chat and goes, I want to be a part of it, and then you don't bother, then you start playing your own video game.
Unicorn says your endorsement has failed.
Dollar Shave Club, probably not a sponsor of this.
Successful Geek says, you really should try Harry's tea and see what you think compared.
Well, if Dollar Shave Club says, you know, no bueno on the refund, then yeah, I may go to Harry's.
Marv says he shaves up on his neck. It's shaving down is awkward.
Well, I would say...
Play
I would
shitty games, get shitty prizes.
Your mileage may vary. I will tell you that. Your mileage may vary.
But on your face, definitely. I mean, your face is more sensitive. The skin is more...
It's almost as if...
Mark says, did you see the bread I acquired in the early hours of the
spring? I did see your bread. Well done. That's some serious baking right there. Well done, Marv. Seriously, well done.
Kika says, razor burn is always my greatest enemy.
And I would say to combat that, you really do want.
Successful Geek says, this is actually an ad for Harry. This is some Old Spice level shit.
It really is.
Stressful as fuck. Yeah.
What was that?
I don't know. Was he talking about his bread?
Oh, no, he's talking about the bread. He's talking about the bread. The bread was stressful.
Unicorn says, Twitch dad advice on having no backup razor. Well, when you have one handle and three razors, you would think that...
And everything was working fine before you switched out razors? Yeah. The Twitch dad advice would be, start writing to someone at the Dollar Shave Club and say, why the fuck are my replacement blades not working?
Yeah.
Because this is no bueno.
I'm gonna go on that Facebook page right now. I'm gonna put on my Karen haircut and say I need to speak to the manager.
Yeah, I need to speak to the manager. What's even more embarrassing is that this had to happen on fucking stream. On fucking, not for me. It's not, well, it is embarrassing for me, but it's even worse for Dollar Shave Club. Because I'm like, hey, I love your product. I wanted to give you guys some love, and your product failed miserably.
Failed hard.
On stream, not once, not twice, three effing times.
There's something wrong with the handle. Yeah.
Meanwhile, but no, here's the thing. Right now, I am tugging. It's locked in, and I'm tugging and I'm wiggling against the blade.
Yeah.
And then I try to shave with it. And it's just, I'm just hobbling through it. I want to finish it, though, because I really don't want. I'm not going to say I fixed it. Because the minute I say, oh, hey, look, it's working,
just
it's going to snap. What's that?
Go streaming, never easy.
I think what he means is like, you know, when you go live with something like this.
That's gonna happen, yeah.
Because how do I rehearse this? That's the other thing. You can't rehearse a shave.
Live streams are fun no matter what, to be honest.
That is true. That is true. That is true.
What about?
You know, it's also fun playing War Dragons when you're supposed to be moderating somebody's channel.
I'm not playing War Dragons.
Hey, Dollar Shave, maybe you want to tune in on this stream where your product is failing miserably.
hey, I just noticed someone's you about beard oil.
Okay. Okay. No, it is not. It is not. Beard oil. So beard oil is for people like, if you've ever been to our podcast, there's a, we had a voice director on our podcast.
Yeah.
And, he is one of those guys who's got one of those epic beards. Not like this. Not like this. I mean, we're talking one of those beards where he's got breadth. He's got, he doesn't have a neck beard, but he's got like length to it. And those kind of beards are a it's like my friend Ben Howard.
Oh yeah.
He actually tried to manicure his beard, and his beard was so big that he was unable to handle it. So he actually went to a professional, and it's night and day how his beard looks. But beard oil, and then, you know, actually the people who make this this stuff, the 1821 stuff, these people actually make beard oil as well. If when your beard is this fashion, it really it's too short to get dry. It could get it could get very prickly, but usually just washing your face, taking care of your face, that's gonna help. But when you have a beard like, I'm trying to think of some good people that we know.
A lot of
steampunks have long beards. Here's one for my stream. If you've ever seen a guy named Dammit to Hell, he's got a big old beard. He's got a big old like hardcore beard. Another guy with a big beard that also used beard oil.
Unicorn says Grizzly Adams.
Grizzly Adams, he needed beard oil. And then of course you've got people like Bonge. Bonge also has a big beard. The Bonge has a big beard. He's the Welshman that you've seen before. Yeah,
Marv says you can rehearse one half and then manipulate the camera to only show the other side of your face.
First try.
Here's one I prepared earlier.
Yeah, exactly. But right now, if you were to ask me what's the difference between shave butter and shave lotion, now that I've struggled through that shave, and of course now it looks like the blade's working now miraculously. I don't know what I did differently, but
you said this looks bad for the Dollar Shave Club.
Yeah, and then suddenly it starts to work. But the nice thing about shave lotion is if you want it, and now granted, lotions change per brand. But this brand right here, 1821, the Shave Glide, you can use it either as an aftershave lotion, or you can use it as the actual lotion itself and just shave with it. I'm putting it on where the shave butter was because it's actually doubling as an aftershave, and I like it. Pip likes it, and after that rough go with the razors. I just want to make sure that I haven't screwed up my face at all. But I do. I think your mileage may vary, but if you have a choice between using shave cream, shave gel, shave lotion, or shave butter, also you want to look at the cost. Because here's the thing. Shave butter and shave lotion are a bit more expensive compared to shaving cream. And shaving cream is cheap. Shaving cream is cheap. But again, I think shaving cream is cheap because it's primarily there for it's there for the razor, to help the razor along. It's not there to help moisturize the skin or anything like that. I mean, a good example is Pip and I belong to a gym, and the gym has disposable razors and cans of Barbasol everywhere. I mean, Barbasol is like the Schlitz of shaving cream. It is cheap as chips. And that's what you're paying for there is basically bulk, and then you've got shave butter. Shave butter is going to be a step up from shave gel. Shave gel is more expensive than shaving cream, and you're shaving lotion.
I want to know, how long does butter last?
Oh, you mean in the bottle?
Mm-hmm. Does it have like a?
It doesn't have an expiration date. You don't have to store it in any special way or anything like that. Granted, if you didn't shave for like months on end, then that might be an issue. But because I'm shaving every day, the shave butter, and they say this again, the shave butter is is an everyday thing. Doing a doing their post shave do, they actually say that for the post shave do, that should be an every other day occurrence as well, which is why I go with the lotion, because the lotion is doing the job of both of these. So I'm still using it as a for shaving.
You've also how many uses you get out of it.
Oh, how many?
How long does that last? That
tube. I still haven't refilled. I still haven't gotten a replacement on this. And this came from the introductory pack. So I've had this for several months, and it's been working fine. Granted, I didn't use it through the month of October because I was letting it the beard grow. But I personally think that the money that you're investing in shave butter and shave lotion is better than saving money on using shave gel or shave cream. I would also say too about going back to beard oil. Beard oil, basically, if you've got a big bushy beard, beard oil is essential. You want to make sure that thing is taken care of, because
it
dries out. Your beard hair will dry out, and it can be very rough to the touch. So you want to use you want to use beard oil for that. I don't think you use beard oil to necessarily use it to shape or trim or shave with. Again, something about shave oil. It's also going to depend on what your skin condition is. If you've already got oily skin, then maybe adding more oil to it might be an issue. So since I've never used shave oil or tried it before, I don't know if it's for me or not. But I know that I'm no longer using using shaving cream or shaving gel. I'm using strictly lotion or butter, and I think it works great. I think it works great. So now my beard is now back to the way it was.
Pretty much.
God, it feels good.
Oh yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And now I'm just gonna have to keep an eye on it, and just when it starts to get a little long, it's when I go back to the groomer. Again.
Bruises, it's definitely a process.
Yes, it is a process. And everybody's grooming technique is going to be different. Like, when I let my beard grow out, I tried a Fu Manchu look once where it was like a really long. I had you remember that?
Yeah.
I did the long beard just to try something different. I didn't like it, neither did Pip.
All right. It's nice to see your beard back, baby.
Yeah, thank you, baby. I did try the longer beard look, and I, like I said, didn't care for it. But that was when I noticed my beard tends to grow long. And it tends to grow out. It doesn't grow lengthwise. And another reason why you would want to use... Oh, there's also beard wax. Now, what is beard wax for? That's for somebody like... there's a friend of ours,
Dave Robinson.
Dave Robinson's got that beard that goes long. So he's like using wax on. He's curling it. And Brand Gamlin, another friend of ours, he also does a curl. That's how they maintain the curl. They're using some sort of beard wax. And there are beard waxes that have moisturizer in them so that they moisturize the beard, the shape facial hairs wear well. But when you start sculpting beards like that, that is high maintenance. For me, just keeping this beard this close and this trim, this is high maintenance for me. But I'm just not a neck beard guy.
How often do you have to trim it to keep it like that?
I have to trim it every day.
Yeah.
And that's why... which is why I'm a little concerned that if I'm having issues with this razor,
yeah,
it's one thing to struggle with it on stream, but in the mornings, I've got to make sure that my razor works.
Don't fling it around too much.
I just want to see if it flings off. All right. So what about aftershave? Well,
you don't use aftershave, do you?
Well, sometimes I use this stuff.
What have you got there?
Play. Timberlake scent. Milked from his third nipple. Don't you remember that?
It must be very expensive.
Milk, yes. Essence of Timberlake.
Essence
of Timberlake, right here. Hang on, and there it is. Play. But I've gone away from using. No Aqua Velva, Nate Fu. My God, that's going back. That was actually my first ever aftershave, and I remember. I remember thinking I was so hip and so smooth because I was using Aqua Velva.
What does it smell like?
It smells like ass, baby.
Oh,
it smells like ass and alcohol.
Oh,
It smells like a dark corner of San Diego that Nate Fu and I probably walked by a couple of times that night. It's just yeah. But the thing is, again, going citing American Psycho, citing American,
burns.
Exactly, it burns.
Minty turpentine
burns his ass. It's just minty turpentine. And pee. It's just not good for you. And that's the thing about aftershave. If you are going to use aftershave, the one thing I would say, or if you're using cologne in general, I mean, it's alcohol-based. And again, citing American Psycho, that dries out your skin. So one thing that you'll hear people talk about is, you know, instead of splashing your face with this stuff, a good idea is to spray a couple squirts in your hand, put a dab here, dab here, dab here, dab here. And that's going to help. That's going to help trigger the scent of whatever cologne you're wearing, because it comes from points of heat, you know, pulse points. So that's where. So and that way you can get the benefits of aftershave or the benefits of cologne without slathering your face in it. And yes, there are some cultures and there are some individuals who, in lieu of bathing, they will douse themselves in cologne. And
says he uses Old Spice.
Well, and you know what? Old Spice? Nothing wrong with Old Spice.
Haven't they got all different smells now?
They've got all different kinds of smells for Old Spice now. They got all different kinds. But the thing to keep in mind is, if you're using an aftershave or if you're using a cologne, it is alcohol based. It will dry out your skin. So you want to use as little of it as possible. And if someone says, "Well, I'm using it in lieu of a shower," that's just gross. That's just gross.
Bathing in aftershave.
And I know for some places it's a cultural thing, and I'm not bagging on anybody's culture, but I'm going to tell you that the thing about cologne is that it only lasts for so long, and that's why when a lot of people wear cologne, they wait until they're going out, because by the time they get back, that cologne smell is gone. It's usually replaced by the smell of beer and cigarettes, but that's another story for another time.
Null says it's concerning the amount of life advice we're mining from certain movies.
but the thing is, it's kind of accurate.
It is true.
It's not it is disturbing, but the thing is, where else do you learn this stuff?
I don't know. Well, Unicorn said he follows after his dad.
Right.
So what did your dad wear?
My dad wore Drakkar.
Drakkar. Ooh.
My dad was a Drakkar Noir guy. He was a Drakkar Noir. And he thought he was being fancy when he wore Drakkar Noir.
Oh,
really? Yeah.
Driving a Porsche.
Exactly. Exactly. But again, my dad would, he would apply it on his cheeks.
Yeah.
And,
That's rough on you.
It's like, and my dad looked it. My dad looked it. He had
a good skin for, you know.
Well, the other thing I didn't do that my dad did, my late father was also an official in baseball.
So he was out in the sun.
So he was out in the sun. He was out in the sun a lot, and it, you know, and he, and also when you're out in a baseball field, especially if you're working infield, there's all the sand and dirt from around the bases. So that's going to get into your skin as well. Now, that being said, my dad never passed up a chance to spoil himself. He liked going to spas.
He
didn't
mind a mani-pedi.
He didn't mind a mani-pedi. He did not mind a mani-pedi. And he also didn't mind that. However, he was claustrophobic. So because he was claustrophobic, he wouldn't let people do facials or anything like that on, which he desperately needed because he had a lot of crap in his skin.
Yeah.
But again, this goes back to just taking care of yourself.
So of these things that you're doing, is there a moisturizer of any kind in this?
This stuff.
That stuff's got a moisturizer.
This has got the whole point of shave lotion and shave oil. Again, I'm going to point this out to you because this product works. This stuff has moisturizer in it.
Okay, that's good.
So you can use shave lotion or what the Dollar Shave Club calls their post-shave dew. It's pretty much just an aftershave lotion.
It's a moisturizer.
It's a moisturizer.
Dew.
Yeah. Moisturizer.
Yeah.
But they're trying to make it sound manly. And again,
dew
this comes...
manly?
What?
Dew.
I have no idea. I honestly, this.
It's moisturizer, man. Get over it.
Would you like to be on the stream? No. I can leave. I can leave. And if you want to play War, now where she was playing
Does
War Dragons.
Aloe?
Do what?
Does it have aloe?
Does this stuff have aloe? Let me double check.
That's pretty good.
It is very good for the skin. Let me find out. Oh, right in big black letters with aloe vera and jojoba.
Oh, those are good for your skin, yeah.
And again, this for some reason, some people think, oh, that's, you know, that's just kind of gay to do. Well, you know what? Here's the thing. You ever notice gay gentlemen? Great skin. And they look good for their age. It's because they're taking care of themselves.
Yes.
So, you know what?
We should all take care of ourselves.
We should. We should all go on ahead and take care of ourselves.
Gets 2 points for guessing there's a low in
there. Yep, 2 points for unicorn.
Jojoba, though, would have been...
Is it what?
Jojoba? Jojoba?
It sounds better than Jojoba.
Jojoba.
It sounds like a character from Star Wars.
I don't know.
You've got to get the secret plans from Jojoba. And his skin is fabulous. But anyway, that's beside the point. All right.
There's nothing wrong with looking after yourself.
No.
No matter who you are.
And the nice thing, the thing I like about the routine I have, is that I will do the prep scrub. I do use the lotion. I like the way it feels. I like the way my skin feels. I don't feel like I've nicked my face or cut a bitch with when the razor works. But I do feel like I'm also slowing down. I slow down when I take
care
of myself.
Jonathan says, take 15 minutes for yourself.
I'm really beginning to regret having her as my moderator. Anyway,
yeah, too late now.
Too late now.
You
so,
smell nice,
I should tell
chat that you smell nice.
I do smell nice. I smell of spiced tobacco. That's the scent that I have here. Any skin, and that's the thing I like about this. Any skin, any razor. And again, this is 1821 Shaving Glide. If you want to check them out, do a search for them online. They've got a website. What's really nice though about their stuff, they also do a shampoo, but the shampoo from a distance looks like a bottle of bourbon.
Don't drink it.
It's kind of cool. Don't drink it. It's kind of cool.
Unicorn says skin types are different. Find what works for you. That's true.
Yeah, but what I like about this stuff is that they claim it works for any skin type.
Yeah.
So whether you've got dry skin or whether you've got oily skin, this shave lotion should work well. And depending on who you talk to, when I bought it from Lifetime Fitness where they had that. They have a spa there. They had a men's section. I looked it up. And that's the other thing too. The men's section of a lot of stores, they go for either the sport scent or the wood scent. And I don't know how a wood smelling like a tree is manly, but...
It's wood.
It's wood. You're sporting wood, I guess. But this stuff has got a really unique scent to it. It's nice. It's nice. It works for me. So I've covered basically shaving... The shaving and the sculpting of a beard, and then I'm now back to normal-ish. So does anybody have any questions? And as you're considering your questions, because I am going to... I want to keep these Twitch Dad streams simple, and I want to keep these Twitch Dad streams also short. No more than 2 hours.
Noel says, the trees are swole.
Maybe.
The trees
are very swole.
I mean, you got to punch them.
They can take a hit. All right, so a couple of people were talking about being able to take this trimmer into the shower.
Can you shave in the shower?
You can shave in the shower. The trick is trying to find a mirror that will truly not fog up on you. So you got to find an anti-fog mirror to make sure that you do that.
That's true, yeah.
Now, When you pick up these trimmers, these personal groomers, these are called personal groomers because not only do they take care of your face, they take care of the other parts of your body, which is armpits, which is hair, chest hair, back hair if you got a friend, and then, of course, the naughty bits, which brings us to the very awkward portion of the stream. Places we don't like talking about taking care of, but we need to take care of. I'm going to talk about manscaping in just a second.
Oh.
We're not going to do it on stream. Let's just get that straight out of the box. We are not doing it on stream. But I do want to talk about this. This right here is made by Wahl, W-A-H-L. We're going to talk about the most unpleasant of grooming. Well, yeah, unpleasant of grooming.
I've got a question.
Ear and nose. Yes, what's the question?
Kika Senko, what do you suggest to use for sensitive skin? Like, is there some sort of product that would help stop razor burns?
That's going to be either butter or lotion. Gel will not work. Shaving cream will definitely not work. But I would suggest either butter or lotion for that.
It's got that sort of creamier.
Yeah, yeah, and it's going to have moisturizer in it. The shave butter, for example, that I've got here, real quick. Let me just take a closer look at it. It's for external use only, which I got there. Comfortable, convenient, and customized shave. Got that. In here, you've got ginseng root extract. You've got pineapple fruit extract. You've got papaya extract. You've got willow bark extract. I'm not seeing any aloe or aloe vera or anything like that. A lot of leaf oil. I've seen leaf oil in here. But basically, shave butter will help moisturize the skin. Shave lotion will definitely do it.
Successful Geek says that they go clean shaven and they use the trimmer in the shower to shave down short.
Right.
And then raise the shave once they get out. So yeah.
But let's talk about this because nobody does want us to talk about this, and I had to learn this the hard way. When I was growing up, I used to get really bad unibrow. I would get hair up here, and this is one way of taking care of it. This is a Wahl detail trimmer. They call this for detailing. If I had darker eyebrows, I would use this to detail my eyebrows if I wanted to do that. I primarily use something like this for ear and nose hair. These most of the time are battery operated. Yes, this one works. And this is how it works. You basically do this. You notice I am not shoving this into my ear. Don't do that. All you need to do is run this along your earlobe and along the outer ear around its edge. It will heat up. That's normal. This does not improve your hearing in any way, shape, or form.
So, Mom, don't use it for your hearing.
But I will tell you this about it. From personal experience, not just being the welder. No, I mean because I'm blonde, or I grew up blonde. My ear hair and my nose hair is blonde, which means I have to watch for it. And it means every other week I'm grooming myself, whether I need to or not, in my ears. But the personal story was when I was having a conversation with a high up academic Shakespearean scholar when I was in college. And I was working so hard to keep my eyes locked with his because the forest that he had growing out of his ears was distracting. And he was not a blonde. He was a brunette, which meant it was black. It was black, white, and gray. And it was thick enough that he could twist it if he wanted to. It was gross. It was traumatic. And the minute after we were done that night, I turned to my girlfriend at the time and I said, I need to go and get an ear and nose hair trimmer. I don't want to be like that. I do not. And I don't know what it is why people don't.
I think it's weird. As you get older, hair comes in weird places.
Yeah, yeah, hair comes in weird places. And the way these trimmers work is that the blades work. Let me see if I can get this zoom in here. It's going to be out of focus. But the blades... Yeah, that's as best. That's as good as it's gonna get. The blades are inside the tube. All right, the blades are inside the tube. So basically, what you're doing is you are placing the blades on the hair, on the nose, on the ear hair.
So it's not gonna wiggle at your ear. That's interesting.
The only thing that it does is that. If you do not have long, let me rephrase that, Mark. You don't have long ear and nose hair now. Now,
later on,
that may change. I never had this problem until I I kind of overreacted when I saw this dude with the long hair. Granted, he was in his like 50s or 60s. I didn't really start having a problem with this, at least with my ears, until my 30s. And then in my 40s and 50s, it's just maintenance.
As you aged, hair is just like randomly popping up, and you're like, where the hell did that come from?
Exactly. And
like, surprise!
Yeah, if you start having a unibrow situation, you solve it with this. Now, I don't have a unibrow anymore, but basically you just run it along here. You can either run it along the side, or you can just run it straight down.
About 38 for him. That would be about right.
Yeah. That sounds about right.
Somewhere in your 30s.
But, you know, and they have, like...
My mom says, I'm still sexy. I'll be like this forever.
I believe it. I believe it.
You hang on to that, Marv.
I believe it. Now Marv is wishing you were playing War Dragons. Pretty sure. Okay. The ear hair, the maintenance of ear hair is pretty straight up.
How often do you have to do that?
I do it, like I said, I do it every other week.
Okay.
Do it every other week. And I also do, even if I've already done it every other week, if I've got an appearance coming up, if I got a book signing or a convention that I'm going to.
You don't want a young man staring at your ears.
Nope. I was doing this right before TwitchCon. I wanted to make sure that I didn't. It's like, have you seen the old guy, the old streamer who's got the ear and nose hair issue? Damn. So nose hair is a little different of to deal with, and so here it's a two-step process. So first off, you've got to have the trimmer on hand. Next thing you got to have is this. Have a tissue on hand. This does go, and that's the thing. This does go into the nostril. There is a technique to it, but this does go up into the nostril. And that's why when you look at different personal groomers, particularly the detail ones, they're either going to look like this or they're going to actually look like a small wand. This did come with a... No, it does not. This one did not come with it. It was a different make that I had. It had a very thin trimmer that literally looked like a stick with blades on the edge. And that was... I regret using that because I feel like that could have done a little harm if I had gone.
That sounds awful.
I know.
Dangerous.
It sounds like a torture device.
Powered up in your brain.
Exactly. But this one is pretty self-explanatory. But how you do it is you go into the nostril, but don't go straight up. Lean to the side. I'm going to lean into the mirror now. Lean into the side, and then stretch out just a little bit, and then you're going to work in circles. You'll know when you've reached maximum capacity with how far you want to go up. But it's either this or use tweezers.
Telling
you right now, I used tweezers once, and it was just unpleasant. But then again, the nose hair was coming out so far I could see it, and it was actually starting to curl around the nostril. That's when you've let it go too long. So here we go.
Looking like Cthulhu.
Pretty much. The worst bit is you can hear it working. That's the worst bit of it.
Does it ever like this?
No. It does make your eyes water somewhat and you feel like you're going to sneeze. But
that's probably because you're missing with your eyes, right?
Yeah, but the other thing is that when the thing starts getting hot, that's when you're like, oh, that can't be good. So you have the tissue on hand for two reasons. One, you just wipe it down just in case it gets a little runny. And then of course you do this to clear out the nasal passages. I will say this: depending on how thick your nose hair can get, I know that sounds gross. Just bear with me, everybody.
We're all humans,
and our bodies are disgusting and are disgusting machines. You'll actually
except for Marv.
Marv is a Greek Adonis. Okay, he is a dark skinned Greek Adonis. And I miss feeling him next to me. Anyway.
I'm right here, dude.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were playing War Dragons.
Ah.
Okay. Anyway. But what I was going to say was, before I was interrupted by the peanut gallery, the thing I've noticed about when I trim my nose hair is I actually breathe better.
Huh.
That is not a thing. I actually feel like I breathe better.
Huh. Sounds good.
All right, so here we go.
I think Marv was thinking about his ears. See your ears, Marv. How do you know?
But here's the thing. Nose hair and ear hair, it happens to everybody, men and women.
Eventually.
But nobody wants to talk about it. Well, here's the thing. You got Twitch Dad with you, and I'm here to talk about it because it makes me uncomfortable,
Twitch
but
Dad
I'm doing it.
Talk about it. That's the thing about being a good parent. You talk about uncomfortable things because you have to.
And then sometimes you try to talk about uncomfortable things with your daughter, and it winds up making things worse.
That's right.
You learn by example. You learn by doing. Okay. Oh. Excuse me.
I think maybe Marv's worried now that he has got ear hair. He just
I think he said my ears based on. He said my ears based on me talking about holding them close.
Yeah. You might
want
to check your ears, Marv.
Now, one other thing, though, about these personal trimmers or these detailers, they are designed to not only work dry, but also you can clean them out. So if you feel weird about going back to your ears after you've worked in the nasal cavity for a bit,
give it a clean.
And to do that, you just run the water through here. Run the water over the tip, just the tip. Lana, just the tip. And make sure that when you dry it off, make sure that it's off. You don't want to necessarily have this running and then put a tissue onto it, because then that can screw up the blades. One last pass. And then for good measure, after this is done, and honestly, I do feel like I breathe better. I've been breathing better because I've been maintaining that. Again, this is Wahl, W-A-H-L, and these also run about $20. Fox with the host. Thank you very much for that host, Fox. I appreciate it. I do appreciate it. All right. And Fox, what a time to choose to host, because now we're going to talk about manscaping. Because we're not going to do it on stream.
Just watch as everyone runs away.
We're not, and watch my listener, my viewership drop. Manscaping. What can one say? All right. This goes for men and women. And but first, let's talk about the manly bits. Some people may say that the manscaping is not a manly thing to do, but you know what? If your preferences ask for someone to be shaven in certain areas or trimmed in certain areas, what's good for the goose, what's good for the Untitled Goose Game is good enough for the Untitled Gander Game as well. I just got another host. I'm talking about manscaping. You're playing War Dragons again! Yeah. And that's Almond Milk with the host. I know, Fox, this is what you walked in. Wait, what? So here's the thing.
Wait, what?
Yeah, exactly. Fox, you picked a hell of a time for a host, baby. So I'm gonna leave it at this. There are sites that will give you tips, but I'm gonna tell you this right now. You're going to want to use using shaving butter or shaving lotion for that particular area of your bodies. Probably a bit of an indulgence. This stuff will work just fine. I would suggest using shaving gel if you're going to start doing some manscaping or ladyscaping. But I got asked a question about this from author Piper Drake. She said, "What are your thoughts on waxing?"
Why?
And here are my thoughts. Men, if you do that to your lower regions, your partner, be they male or female, pretty much everything's on the table. The excuse, "No, honey, we can't do that. It's not your birthday," off the table. off the table. Everything's up for grabs. Just let that soak in. Everything's up for grabs.
Oh, Al Moakes is hi, Twitch Dad. when I was imagining
Almond Milk just said this is not what I pictured when he was talking about shaving. Well, okay. Almond Milk, you missed the earlier shaving bit. But yeah. And I just got a follow, so I'm doing something right. And that was Car Girl. Thank you very much for that host. For that follow. I do appreciate the follow. I haven't gotten any subs, but I appreciate the follow.
Yeah, but you're going to do some more Twitch dating.
I am going to be doing some more Twitch dating in the future. But yeah, just final note. You want to be careful. You just want to be careful when you're doing that. Take your time. Do never do any sort of manscaping or netherscaping when you're in a rush. Give yourself some time. And
or drunk.
Or God, no, never drunk. That's like going tattoo. That's like getting tattoos when you're drunk. You don't want to do that. But if you do that, I'm going to recommend you get one of these. You want to use a personal groomer. And because they are built for not only dry shaving but wet shaving as well, you can go ahead and use them in the shower. Just make sure you got plenty of steam going and time. But this is for if you're doing a lot of cleanup down there. This is for when you want to do detail work. Now, one more. She thinks this is funny, but she will agree with me. She would agree with me.
It just sounds like, you know, you're gonna roll up in a.
Everyone's feeling very uncomfortable. But here's the thing: would you rather just kind of fake it? No, you came here to talk to Twitch Dad. So guess what? This is what Twitch Dad's gonna give you some truthiness right now. He's gonna give you some truthiness.
You know, it is like one of those awkward conversations with your dad.
Now, I will say this though. Make sure you have a separate razor for that sort of thing. This is a personal choice.
Kika Sanchez says this is quality content.
But going ahead and
not uncomfortable. Fox says not uncomfortable. Just imagining doing it in a rush, and I'm like, ow.
Yeah. That's why you don't want to do it in a rush. Take your time, especially the first couple of times you do it. Just take your time. Your hot water bill may go up a bit, but that's okay. Take your and again, I'm just gonna say this. Don't go against the grain. All right. But yes, go on ahead and make the investment. Get a second razor. Just don't mix up the two. It's like mixing up the your thermometers. You know what I'm talking about? Okay.
So don't use a straight razor down there.
No, God. No, in your case, Adam, go ahead and use Leviathan's breath. All right.
It'll take everything right off.
Take everything clean off. All right. Did anybody have any questions for me at this point? While you're formulating your questions, I will say there will be another Twitch Dad stream. This was a really fun experiment. I had a great time doing this. And I think the next experiment that I'm going to do with Twitch Dad is going to be how do you tie a tie?
That's a good one.
Because what I've been told is that there are some people who do not know how to tie a tie. And I'm going one step further. I'm going to do the standard Windsor knot, which if you've never seen before, I mean, but you've seen it. I mean, it's the most common tie knot that you'll see anywhere, but it's the Windsor knot.
Can you just reiterate why you don't go against the grain, just in case?
Ingrown hairs.
Yeah. That's pretty much the
reason. If you think they're bothered up here and you go against the grain.
Don't get them down there.
I'm just saying, down. That's gonna be painful. A lot of itching. But I'm gonna do the Windsor knot because a lot of people don't know the Windsor knot. I'm also gonna go through and I'm gonna look at some other knots that some people call exotic. But I'm gonna try to find. I'm just gonna find one and run with that, and then teach you something other than a Windsor knot. The nice thing about the Windsor knot, just as a quick teaser, one of the things about the Windsor knot, the reason why it's so popular is one, it's easy to learn. And two, it's also very easily adjusted. So that's why you see so many Windsor knots. We're going to do a Windsor knot, We're going to do an exotic necktie knot, so you can have that variety if you want to change it up. But the third thing I'm going to teach, and I'm looking forward to teaching this. I don't know how I'm going to teach it. I'm going to try to do something similar to what we did here with the mirror reflection. But the other thing I want to teach people is how to tie a bow tie.
Oh, yes.
Because now I'm a steampunk, so I'm wearing bow ties. But even before I got into steampunk, I've always liked the look of a bow tie. And I don't just mean a bow tie. I'm talking about that classic Sinatra thing where at the end of the day, you just pull the bow tie apart and it just hangs. And you got that Dino Sinatra. I've got my bourbon in one hand. I got my microphone in the other, and I'm going to croon to you, baby. I mean,
some of the comments are quite funny.
What?
Noel says, honestly, after listening to your work for over a decade, getting advice on manscaping just seems par for the course. It's good advice, too. Fox wanted to know if you were speaking from experience about ingrown hairs.
Yes. Yeah, just straight up, yes. Yes.
Successful geek, how terrifying would a steampunk manscaper look?
Well, first off, it's what you're using the manscape with, and if it's a steampunk device, it's going to be twice as big as it normally should be, and it's going to have a lot of gears involved, which means with the dangly bits, that's you're taking your life in your own hands. You're going to be singing Soprano in a minute, okay, bud? Any other legit questions that people had for me?
Ouch!
Yeah.
Ouch.
Oh, my God. I knew this was going to be a wacky stream, but, man, my face feels good. Oh, my face feels good.
We should go and hang up some Destiny stuff downstairs.
We've got some stuff to hang up downstairs. But anyway, I just want to say for this being the first time I've ever done an exclusive Twitch Dad stream, this was a lot of fun.
Well, you got some more people in the house.
Oh, I got some new folks.
0161 crew.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for being here. I do appreciate it. What was that?
Fox says, I'm sure Twitch mom is happy that the beard is back. Yes!
Twitch daughter is going to be ecstatic because it's like, daddy's come home. Yes. Where the hell is dad been?
Where's that other guy?
First there was the guy who was 12 claiming to be my dad. And then there's the guy who had the neck beard. So, I mean, nothing against neck beards. If you can pull off a neck beard, I have respect for you, but I am not that guy. I am not that guy.
Well, I like it. It frames your face nicely.
Did anybody have any other questions for me before I start? Checking out. Well, interesting. I just looked at my bit rate and I saw there were quite a few drops. I apologize about that. If things were a little choppy, but oops. Oh, there's Lulu. There's Lulu. Maybe we should go host Lulu.
I hope everyone.
that's hardcore moderation right there.
Yep.
When the moderator throws out a test, that's when you know you better be paying attention, son. So let me just go ahead and do a quick.
We're gonna go raid somebody.
Well, let me ask you real quick, chat. Did this work for you? Did the setup where I'm talking in the mirror and were you able to see everything? And again, I apologize about the razor. I guarantee you, after this stream, this razor is going to be faultless. It's going to be absolutely faultless.
But you can't pass because of the dragons.
Oh, that was a sick burn. Sick burn. Burn!
I'm just going to go play War Dragons now.
All right. Let's see who's on. Oh, wow. Lulu must be featured somewhere because she's got nearly 1,000 people watching her in real time. Good on her. So I tell you what, let's go on ahead and let's raid iLulu. Real quick little Twitch note, which is extremely cool. If you're using the new dashboard, instead of having to by hand type in raid / and making sure you've got the person's name spelled right, which I've had an issue with in the past. If you use the raid channel function in the new dashboard on Twitch and you're a streamer, it actually will show you what channels are currently active. And all you got to do is touch the channel and you go, which I think is extremely cool. But here's what we're going to do. We're going to go ahead first. I'm going to drop in the message I want you all to drop into her feed. And yep, that's right. We're going to go on ahead and we're going to copy that message in the chat. And then when we raid Lulu's stream, that's what you're going to do. You're going to go on ahead and you're going to give her some of that monster love. I was going to end with some music, but I think we'll just go on ahead and we'll just end stream. But right now, let's raid Lulu. But first off, everybody, thank you all so much for the tips, the bits, the subs, and the host, and the questions, and going through the awkward phase of talking about what you do to take care of yourself. Because, and actually, I think...
Yeah.
War Dragons?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I thought. And having a moderator of infinite renown.
Well, you can look at your own damn comments now, can't you?
Wow. Marital bliss. This is what ZG Photo has to look forward to. All right. So thank you, everybody. This has been a lot of fun doing the first ever Twitch Dad stream. I'm now going to wrap it up. Send the love to Lulu. I appreciate all of you being here. Because tomorrow is a holiday and because I'm working remote, there will be a stream tomorrow morning, bright and early, 5 a.m. It will be me and Destiny 2, probably on PS4. It's tempting to do PC, but I'm probably going to do PS4 just to keep it simple. And again, thank you, everybody. It's been a blast. You go and share the love with Lulu, and I will talk to you all later. Thanks again, everybody, for being here. It's been a blast.